Patrick Kelly, the designer from Vicksburg, Mississippi, has captivated the press and the public from America to Paris to Tokyo and the world in between. And now he's capped it all off by becoming the first American ever elected to the elite French couture designers organization. And that organization is called the Chambre Syndicale. His made in France fashions show both his wit and his wisdom, his serious talent for creating fashions that are fun. Now with Warnaco backing him, Patrick Kelly is expanding rapidly with 60% of his sales in the United States and a booming demand in Europe and the Far East. As for the woman who wears his clothes, they have nothing in common. It isn't their age, there's only one thing, and that's Kelly's fashion's appeal to women from 20 to 80, who have a certain sense of style, a certain ability to feel comfortable with themselves, a certain longing for clothes that make them smile. FIT is honored to welcome Patrick Kelly, the American in Paris.
There's still an option, but if you, since you're here at FIT, try to go through and be able to say I did it. And I there's a lot more I could tell you, but it's easier doing the show. So I hope that Michael McCoy has those girls ready back there. And these are girls who have donated their time to you, and they're top professional girls. Some of them have come from Paris. So I hope you like it. And afterwards, you can ask me a few questions. I'm kind of running afterwards, but I'll answer as many as I can, and I'll try to give out as many buttons as I can. And if I don't have enough, don't be mad at me. Okay. So can somebody give me some music? I'm gonna get out of here. They're prettier to look at than me. All right.
But I don't need- courses. And you can add dental courses too.
So they'll stay as long as they can, and so who's gonna work with me with the courses? Oh, I just like them. I'll get you some, I promise.
I want a baby.
A baby? A baby? No, I'll get you one. Okay. You're definitely loud.
Okay. When you first started, did you, I read in an article you said you went over to town. The first thing that you went over when you got off the plane,
what did you do? Look for a job. No, really, I did. I was looking for a job, and I tried to learn a little bit of French, but I was from Mississippi, so my French sounded like Portuguese or something. And I know I started to look for a job, and I did like maybe 25 portfolios. So when you all complain that you can only do one portfolio, it's not the truth. I did like 25. Every weekend I was doing another. When I went to see Givenchy, I made one. When I went to see Saint Laurent, I made another one. I mean, each time I went to see somebody, I tried to give it to them. I'll sign it afterwards, I promise. Uh-huh. Do I use illustrators? I illustrate myself. Sometimes I use illustrators, but usually if you design, you know, they give you the business if you can't sketch. They say, oh, they can't even sketch. So I usually do my own illustrations.
Uh-huh. Do you do all of your own designs? Help.
I do my own, but I have help. Everybody needs help in everything you do in this world. No, right now I got three people that if they knew you was asking, me and you would be in trouble. I can't hear you. Prince? Yeah, I work with too many prints. You know, usually they label black people for making jersey and a lot of prints. It's not true. We do everything.
Prince?
They're singing? Not with him directly. We sell clothes to, we sell clothes to the people who buy from him in the shop. But there are a lot of entertainers that we do work with, like Jody Watley, Betty Davis. In fact, she's receiving the Lifetime Achievement Award today, and she's wearing the evening gown with me. Oh, I'm still waiting on the first break.
No,
really, I mean, if you think that you've already made it and you're at the top, you have nowhere to go but down. So if you continue to go up, you can keep going. They're fed up. They're going to go out and they're going to do some kids. Everybody you saw on the stage is my favorite model. No, but if I don't say that, can you imagine having a favorite model when these people came up here and worked for free for us? I have a lot of them. Like, my daughter in the red there, Janet. She's my daughter.
Janet!
Well, she's probably undressed and ready to go see a boyfriend by now. Well, she's back over there somewhere. Any other? Yeah. Inspiration? I like old women because I think they're chic, you know. I like stealing ideas from them, the street. I like museums, but I'm really fast in a museum. You know, most people can be in there 3 hours wondering about the light hitting this. After 30 minutes, I'm gone. Well, it's the only one I got. Yeah, but I do get a lot. I do get a lot. I get a lot of criticism from blacks and from whites and from everybody about who I am and my image. And what the blacks, they always say that if you can't deal with where we've been, it's going to be hard to go somewhere. And with the whites, I hope they like it. You know, we took Amos and Andy off the TV because they depict blacks in a bad way, they said, right? But you think everybody white is like Lucille Ball? We'd be in trouble.
experience racism everywhere, but I don't have time to bother with it, because even if you went to Mars, you'd find a turquoise Martian, you'd find a lime green Martian, you'd find all kind of green men, and they wouldn't get along with the other green men, so you have racism everywhere. Yeah, it should be soon. I don't know the exact date, and they won't let me talk about it, but it's coming out soon. I'm sorry. Oh, okay. Right there. I'm sorry to point. Yeah. Do I understand French? Yeah. Huh? Don't ask me in French then. No. I want to answer to everybody else. They're going to think I'm mad. They're going to say, he's so pretentious. He came here speaking French. No, ask me in English. But you can't show me now because I've got to get a lot of other questions. But if you make an appointment and call us to our office and send me some stuff, I'll look at it. I have to give you that. I mean, they're going to kill me if I answer this kind of like an employment question. In the Moray, in fact, right across from the Picasso Museum. I got a really great location. It's really nice with a garden inside. So in the summertime, we hang out there too. Yeah, of course. Of course. Promise. Yeah. Oh, I know. You say it's fantasy living American fashion. No, I don't believe that. Look at this audience. You know, look at me. I'm American. I mean, I don't think so. A lot of times, they, you know. Us that's just starting, like me and you, we have to change that. We have to give them fantasy even when they don't want it. And then they won't be able to say that anymore. But I don't think so. You know, the press will say anything. They'll say I'm tall and handsome, and I'll believe that. But it won't be true.
Do you have problems with only certain things, like, certain parties will work there, things projected and somebody looks at Patrick Kelly, all they see is like he did work. When in fact you have a variety of things.
Well, I have a lot of problems. Like I said, the journalists report what they want sometimes. Sometimes they say Patrick makes a lot of dresses, a bunch of buttons all over, and they don't see the suits. But you have to get past that and try to sell. The ultimate goal is selling. The journalists are going to love you one season and love you another season and hope they never stop loving you, but sometimes they do. I don't know. I'm just happy. I don't know. I would like to think I would have made it here too. I didn't stick around to find out. You can make it anywhere. Pine Bluff, Arkansas. I was tired. I was just tired. I had been on every interview you could go on. I was standing on my head. And then I had a lucky break. I saw Pat Cleveland one day in the street. And she said, go to Europe. And I said, but I don't have any money. And when I went to see my friend at his beauty salon, there was a ticket to go to Paris. And I kept going. But it's hard to tell you to follow my trip because you may not be willing to do what I did, like sell fried chicken dinners, clean people's houses, sell your clothes on the street and have people say to you it's not cheap and put you down. It wasn't all easy. It wasn't all like Patrick Kelly just arrived and the French loved him. No, I was out there kicking, baby. I've had a lot of luck and God's been really good to me, so I can't say how difficult it is to get one because I've been lucky. I've been falling from grace, I've worked hard. Luck is a friend of mine told me at home, I went to Mississippi originally and said, you're not really lucky, you've worked hard all your life. I used to sell drink bottles with this friend. But as far as to say how hard it is to get a backer and how you have to deal, I've been lucky and I've got a good backer. And I have a good deal with it, but it's going to fall in different ways all the time. But it's good work on the one. Yeah.
How old are you now?
I don't remember. I'm coming, Bobby. Yeah. I stick my nose into everything that's got my name on it. And you have to do that. So that's the biggest goal, man. And then I work overtime, and I make overtime like a vacation. But there's no real format, you know. Each season you come out with a line, and you hope to sell it first, and then you hope the press likes it, because that helps sell it on to the customer.
Right.
Uh-huh.
Okay,
what's happening?
I just wanted to come back. Recently, I read in a report that as far as shipping, creativity, and a lot of other things, you are doing very well.
I hope it keeps going. Where did I get training? Oh, God, everywhere. I used to steal ideas from people that I worked for. I worked for a man named Jack Fuller once. And he was like my hero, because at that time it was Jack Fuller, Stephen Burroughs, you know, blacks identified with blacks. So the only heroes I had was the black designers. And then I went past that and I went to people like Mr. Bean. So I learned from looking at what they did. There was this illustrator named Stephen Mazel. I used to look at his illustrations at W, and I don't know, they were like going to school, because I had him as an instructor, but I skipped all of his classes. He was the only one, because he was mean and I knew I wasn't going to pass. But I learned from his illustrations. But in the end, I started studying from a tailor in Paris, who was a very hard man who beats me to death. In fact, I still go to school. I study under this tailor. And then I went to Parkland's and I had my draping classes and things like that I learned. I believe in school. I just didn't have the money at the time. And I think school is good. It's the best discipline. I just think that sometimes that you forget that you're an adult and the teachers forget that you're an adult and you get lost there. But you're all an adult. And I'm not saying these teachers here or teachers here, but in a general, but you have to conduct yourself like an adult, and then maybe they're gonna treat you like, I don't know what happens. That's what happened to me. I'm not saying that's what's happening in this school, because I always get in trouble when I talk at schools. But when I was going I kind of forgot I was an adult, and they forgot I was, and we got all mixed up and couldn't deal, and the creativity got stumped. But school is the most important. It really is. It's like a big honor. It's like the frosting on the clay, on the cake. The Chambres de Michel is like the most important. You're in ranks with Madame Gray and Mr. Savalon and Sonia Rykiel. It's like a society. It's like the Seventh Avenue Society. It's like the Italian Society of Fashion. It's like the height of what you can do in France. And being the first American, I was like really happy. I was kind of like an ambassador. Nobody elected me an ambassador. I made myself one. So it was a good honor. It made me feel really good. And it gives you credibility.
Yeah.
What's next? Oh, I want to do a bunch of things. I want to take a vacation. I'm gonna make myself a little farm. I have one now, but I haven't had a chance to go to it. I'm going to do menswear in the south of France. And I'm going to do children's wear. And I'm going to do as many things like what I'm doing today with you as I can without getting burnout. Yeah. Where can they be bought? I mean, this really sounds like a political, I mean, a plug at Saks, at Bergdorf, at Martha's, believe it or not, at Bloomingdale's, at, in Paris? Oh, in Vogue Pattern, we do a thing in Vogue Patterns, which we have to give everybody a plug right now. We do a thing in Vogue Pattern. I wrote it in all city cars. No, we do sell some patterns in Vogue Patterns. And in fact, this month in Mademoiselle, there's 6 pages of me teaching you how you can make Patrick Kelly yourself without spending a lot of money. So get a chance, buy it, and see. And it's made just like the tool. It's not some little black and white pictures, do it yourself, kids. It's gonna be really good. Boom. I still. Okay. You're gonna think I'm a mean person, but I swear I can't hear you.
I said, looking back at your achievements, how do you feel now? If you had the chance to do it again, would you have done it?
Yes. You had a chance to do it again. Would you have done it?
Would you do it all?
Give her a mic.
That's an FIT sweater.
If I had a chance to do it again, would I do it again? Oh, I don't know if I had a chance to do it again. I don't have a chance to do it again. That's the bottom line.
Will you come out with like sneakers and perfumes and all that?
Yeah, we're gonna do all of that soon, but you have to take it in time. If you do too much, then they get mad at you. But I wanna do it all. Lingerie, we're working on that too. In fact, all of the licenses are in progress, but when you launch them and how you launch them and how you give them to the press, you have to do slower or do it in a certain kind of way.
How did you come to be
born? Oh, well, it was really strange. Mon Cousin was working with Sonia Raquel, and I love what she did so much, and my business partner knew her. And like when I did my first show, I did it in a kitchen, really, in this house. These people let me do a fashion show. So we did, you know, you hear about doing hair in the kitchen and all kind of things in the kitchen. Where I did my first fashion show out of this kitchen, and I said, Mon, I need some help. And being new, and I guess she realized what talent I had for her, and she decided to do them, and we made a great collaboration, and she ended up being a good friend. So to have someone like Morpheus on interpreting your shoes for your collection is really great, and it saves you a lot.
When you were in Boston, did you have a lot of stifling of your creativity? I'm not a student, but I know a lot of students here, and they have teachers who like make them change designs or change the colors because they don't think it's going to work.
No, nobody stifled for me. I was a bad boy, and I shouldn't have been mad, but I was. I'm being honest with you. They didn't stifle me. They set up a discipline. You make the decision to go to school and learn it. Because first of all, the one thing it took me into 3 years ago to realize, even 3 years ago, that in order to learn, you have to be humble. And most of us are not humble. We don't have time. We already want, when I was at Parsons, I wanted to be Yves Saint Laurent. I didn't want to be a student. I wanted to be already there. And you can't get it that way. And I had to break myself. Sometimes they break you a little bit too hard. But you, in order to learn, you have to be humble. And that's something people take as a sign of weakness. But it's not. It's the most intelligent thing to realize you don't know it. And you need to learn it. In any way you can get it. But I can't say the school stifle you. I can just say you don't open yourself up sometimes. And if you agree to give them your money, you should get all you can out of it. And I'm not someone too who thinks the school systems are the best in the world either, so you won't be able to go and say, you know, I don't know if he was lying or telling the truth. I believe what I'm telling you. I really do. Otherwise, I wouldn't tell you. I wouldn't waste your time. And I wouldn't come up here and I wouldn't go around as much as I could. I really believe these things, you know, but it's just my belief. Okay? Yeah. Who was the first designer I worked with? Oh, I worked with a genius. I don't even consider him a designer. He'd kill me if he heard me say that. He is a big designer. But he was more like a genius for me. I worked with Parker Rabon. And that was the hardest job I ever had. This man was out of his mind. In fact, he should have had some electric shock. But he worked me to death and he never gave in. I mean, he would rip your sketches up in front of you. If you don't like them, fine. Put them on the side. But to have them ripped up, is a bit much, but that was his way. At the end, I learned a lot from him, but he was really tough. He let me have it 24 hours a day. You know, and he could call you like at 4 o'clock in the morning. Let's get over here and get these samples together. I mean, in France, it's a whole nother mentality. You work around the clock the weeks before the collection. Yeah.
What are your standards?
What are my standards? Well, you know, working hard. I got so many, I pick them up as I go along. Like out of this audience today, some of the questions that you've asked me, I'm gonna have to apply them to myself. So the standards get better and better as they go along. I've got one that's really, really cool, and this is not a cop-out. If you don't, nobody needs drugs these days. And if you can do without them, do without them. You know? And I'm not talking God while trying to tell you all the good things you have to do, but take it from somebody who knows. Honey, it is not good. You can go and dance at the chores and the garage. No, the garage is closed. You can dance at all those places. You can dance at all those places and have a good time without being stoned. Because Monday morning when you come into FIT, they don't care what you did on the weekend. They want to see your project. They want to see your sketching. So, and I know there's some people in the audience who's like saying, sure, honey, yeah. And they're on their way to pick up a nickel bag. It's on you, honey. It's on you. Don't do it. Okay, any other questions? I missed it. Okay, the most important thing you need to do is when you finish your portfolio for graduation, that's your portfolio you made for graduation. The minute that you get the diploma in your hand, you sit down for 2 or 3 weeks and you sketch until you fall apart and you make a portfolio for the designers that you're going to see. The one you did for school is for your teachers. You cannot show that. So many times people come to see me with their graduation portfolio. That was to graduate. That was to get your grades and your marks. Put your fantasy to work. Take the time and stop complaining that I need this to work. I need these pencils. I need these. The best two assistants that I've seen in a long time came to me. They went to, one was from Chicago and one was from the school too. And they brought me sketches on paper bags and all kind of things. And it was incredible. They blew me away. And I told them, I said, close it up and go get yourself a job somewhere else because I don't want to be accused of copying your ideas. That's how good they were. You know, but you have to like really do something exciting. You have to realize, if you go to see Mary McFadden, why would you do little mini skirt? You would do some, if you went to see Mr. Jeffrey Bean, why would you do something that looked like sportswear? I mean, you have to know who you're going to see, and sometimes the portfolios you do the graduation don't apply to Marc Jacobs at Perry Ellis or Mr. Samaron. If you went to see Mr. Samaron, for sure you should use a lot of colors, a lot of accessories, or I don't know. And it's just saying, everybody wants to be a designer. I want to be one, and I want to work toward being one. But there are other things you can do too. The girl who's the head of my atelier, my pattern making, is the most intelligent and the most fashion conscious and the most super person in the world. And without her, I couldn't survive. And sometimes you strive past some of the capabilities you have because you think, if I'm not on 7th Avenue or I'm not on the Champs-Élysées, I'm nobody. You can be other things in this fashion world, but you have to be proud of whatever you are. Kimmy is one of my inspirations. In fact, she was going to come with me, but she's fed up with modeling, and she's going to be a singer now. And we really miss her, but we used to use her just to make people crazy because she was this full-figured girl with round everything. She was just a mass of curves, and I liked her so much, and she's really sweet, but she's fed up. We're trying to get her to come into the fashion end of the business and work with me in the atelier because she's really, really a creative girl.
How much time do you spend in America?
Too much. Too much. I do a lot of traveling, a lot of personal appearances to the stores and to the school. Like I said, this was supposed to be really fast, and we're still here having fun. But I spend a lot of time here. I sneak home every now and then to Mississippi to see my mom and everything. And once I was really dumb, I came back when the garage was closing, because I like the garage too. So I came back the night of the garage to go dance, and then my father's like saying, honey, that's a bit expensive to go dancing, but I wanted to do it. You know, and I saved my little coins and I did. Yeah, but I don't like it. I went to one this weekend called Sound Factory. Yeah, and we were like, yeah. And we were dancing and having a good time. All right? Yeah, in fact, I just went to Lagos. I don't plan to go back to Lagos, but I plan to go back to Africa. I was just in Lagos. It was a bit much for me. But I plan to go to Africa. I travel everywhere. We just left Canada doing a show, and we just did a big show for children with AIDS, and we raised over $300,000. So, that was good. I don't know, like my thing is kind of like a fairy tale, what happened to me. It really is. It was hard work, but it was kind of like a fairy tale. And I'd like to think that even here in America, if you knock on enough woods and make enough noise, it seems like in Paris, they accepted me and boom, there it was. But nobody mentions in these articles that in Atlanta, Georgia, I used to sell antique clothes from the ambit to make money to come to New York to buy fabric. It's a whole process. And I think in New York, they're opening up more so than what they've done in a long time. I mean, and when I was here, when I came back the first time after living in Paris, I was invited to see Mr. Bean's show. And some people said to me, how do you like the going to the New York shows? I said, this is the first one I've ever been invited to. When I was here, it was hard to break through. But I don't think it's so hard now. And I think there's other channels. When the industry doesn't let you in, build a new industry. When they wouldn't buy my clothes, I used to sell them on the street of Saint-Germain. When the police would come, I would take them down. When the police would pass, I'd put them back up. And I sold my first collection to Bird Dog off the street when I was in to Bird Dog and to iManagers. And the first collection with a single machine that had to be tied down because I used to pull those jersey dresses through. I made all of them, everyone, with no assistance, with no backers, no business. I fill my orders myself. I'm not telling you, you have to do that. But there are ways to get around it. You have to build too. You know, and being like everybody else, if somebody came to you today and did you, if you became the new designer of Perry Ellis like Marc Jacobs, you'd be just like him. But if you do something different, completely crazy, you're gonna stick out and you're gonna last longer or he's gonna be him. I don't know, you have to make your own way sometimes.
How many characters overall do you have? What kind of statement are you trying to make
wear? Oh, let's see. Well, I have more than 100, and my grandmother won't stop sending me to me. I make my own now, but my grandmother sends me these Liberty ones all the time. I guess Liberty's gonna send me some too. Another company sent me some, and I make them, but it's easy. I mean, if I'm not in my little bicycle shorts trying to be cute dancing, I've got these on, because it's really easy. I fill it up for the pockets, and I've got earrings and lights, and I don't know, it's like a farmer's, not a farmer, like a fireman's uniform. In the morning when I get up, all I have to do is figure out the underwear and the shirt. The rest of it's ready. I'm one of the one designers who read, that's not my ultimate goal. We're gonna have some somewhere, and it works. I used to have a tiny store. I've got one in Paris because that's like the flagship store, but right now it's hard enough getting it to Macy's and hard enough getting it to Bloomingdale's and Bergdorf. I'm going to wait on the store for a little while, but I have a big demand. In California, everybody wants me to open a store, but until I get the image packed down the way I want to, I'm going to wait a while. It's a lot. You have to, like, if you don't take your time with certain things, you just fizzle out, and I want to wait a little while. Oh, thanks for having me. I'm gonna do that. This one, I just swiped it from someone.
Can I say something?
Oh, thanks. I'm a little nervous because if you ask me a question, I have to be honest with you. And a lot of times, you know, when you come to the school, people treat the students like, I don't know, like these little kids, right? But when you ask me a question, you're not dumb, you know everything anyway. You know most of the answers anyway. So if I don't answer you right, I get a little bit nervous up here. So when I come through, I'm gonna get a chance to go through here, or Kim, or all of the girls back there, they're gonna pass out some, because I'm gonna be running.
Stay where you are, please. Those of you who ask a question, would you please stay in your seats because you have to be recorded. You are being taped for a television show. So those of you who ask questions, please, everyone stay, and those of you who ask questions, raise your hands. What? All right. Look at this lady. She's going to tell you what to do. Thank you.
Just sit down while you go.
Thank you very much.